Nama saya Zain Saidin ataupun nama panjang ikut IC Muhammad Zain bin Muhammad Saidin. To be honest, I'm here because my wife aka Rizal Cik Wan, she persisted I come. I was a bit skeptical, one of the knows of the talk. I was skeptical, but you know, to be honest, alhamdulillah, I'm bersyukur lah yeah, I came. It's quite, you know, knowledge, really good knowledge. Banyak I dapat faham daripada dia adalah dia go back to the simple matters. What in our religion Islam is what the simple things in life. To be grateful, kan, bersyukur. Itu adalah orang kata tangga kejayaan. It's simple as that, I see. It's really simple, but we have orang kata lost vision, lost track, kan, sampai kita tak. Benda yang simple pun kita lupa, kita terlampau complicated kan kita hidup sampai tak nampak benda-benda ni. So, I think for me, memang benda ni I tahu, cuma I tak banyak praktikkan. I very skeptical. I think now that I married, I became a father, I lebih nak nampak benda-benda ni tau. So, like this is, orang kata mungkin salah satu my journey yang Allah dah bukakan. Salah satu pintu rezeki yang dibuka, I belajar ilmu. That don't be skeptical, jangan orang kata, bukan nak kata kedekut, tapi jangan tak agak-agak. So, I've learned that and alhamdulillah, I want to practice that. So, insyaAllah, saya nak try buat marketing yang besar dari segi itu untuk expand. Dan actually, dari dulu lagi, memang niat saya adalah membantu keluarga saya. Itu adalah yang pertama, first mana saya mula-mula buat kerja adalah membantu keluarga saya. Dan as time went along, saya nak membantu kawan-kawan keliling saya, my small circle. Dan now I see lah, actually I've noticed this also that macam doktor kata, the more we give, the more we get back, kan? Actually, much more we get back. So, I now understand manfaat untuk orang lain. So, contohnya buat kasut ni untuk membantu orang lain. Contohnya, kasut tu boleh buat untuk pergi kerja. Contohnya, untuk dia orang mencari rezeki dia orang sendiri. So, that I understand now how, orang kata, a chain reaction happens. Switch! Awesome lah, definitely.
After 3 hari, alhamdulillah suara tak ada. Saya tak minta maaf pasal tu. Dah mula orang kata nampak dia punya jalan tu dah clear sikit. Dia kata all the thorns, the bushes ke, the sampah yang kat jalan tu semua dah ketolak ke tepi sikit. And I mean, what he said, his predictions and all that memang tepat lah. Jangan percaya, buat. So, it's clever. And that's what we did. And alhamdulillah, from just buat, kita percaya. So, skeptical tu memang dah kata pupus. First day ada impact, second day dah mula more stronger impact. Obviously today walaupun tak complete lagi kita punya session, tapi still impact dia sangat besar. Because we are very emotional. He makes us understand our reasons, our big why, what not, kan? So we understand why we heading this way. Kita tak macam distracted. We know now it becomes clear why we have to be connected, what is our main, what's our purpose on earth. My kekayaan is more on family matters, making that my family as one, as a unit, we are harmonized. Nak buat benda ni fikir, jangan terlampau. Your goal is not kaya, your goal, macam kita tengok video yang clown tu, the goal is not to be rich, the goal is to have people around you happy. From that happiness, you can gain richness already. And then this opens your eyes. So, that for me, kekayaan. Duit basically, obviously, this dunia, kita nak buat macam mana pun, kita perlukan duit untuk hidup. Bukan kita hidup untuk duit. So, duit ni kita, I want to be bebas from duit, in the sense where I don't want to have to worry about financial problems. I want money to work for me round the clock, and I don't have to work for money. I don't have to, you know what I mean? You get what I mean? I don't have to spend 30 days a month working day in, day out. Actually, to be honest, I'm going to be very honest. I think jujur is very important. I tak siap I punya 101. What is very important for me was the first few was business successful, happy family, anak berjaya. With all this comes everything else akan susul belakang. So tak payah nak risau, all this will come later. When he asked me to write to siapa you nak berterima kasih, siapa you nak minta maaf, I wrote one for my father and I wrote one for my mother. I read what I wrote to my mother and my father, baca kepada dia. Dia pula baca, but I had no idea. She wrote to me. And I thought she wrote to her late father. But she wrote to me, so I was very touched by that. Alhamdulillah. So it was a good moment.